So, yeah, anyway, it was.
Cause I'm not just a pretty girl.
Okay, guys, we're a little out of breath, but we're in the city. It's 13 Reasons Why Day. We're going to see the cast at AOL.
I'm tired. I'm out of breath.
I had an eventful morning. I couldn't find a spot, so then I had to park by a meter. Shout out to Nick. He's going to fill up the corridors for me.
We love Nick.
We love Nick. We love him. And then Angie was all the way in the front of the train.
Because like, I was trying to help Joelle.
Back. So,
is that Nick texting? Oh, it is. We love Nick.
So she was all the way in the front.
I went to the front for her benefit, and then she ended up being in the back, which was my benefit. All the way
in the back. And then I had to run every stop. And I don't run fast enough because I have tiny legs. So it took me 4 stops to get to Angie. And then by the time we got to her, we were getting off the train. But we're still pretty early for the event, so I didn't make us late.
At least it's not raining.
Oh my god, I know. Ah! Now we're walking. Hopefully it's not too crazy.
Well, we only could have saw Justin if we went in. This is old kid.
Oh my god.
Remember, we are Wendy's.
It closed down. That's
sad. It's like around the block or something.
We were literally over there. We were literally in Wendy's and Justin Bieber was right next door to us and we just had no
idea. And we were gonna go inside, but then we didn't.
We just like
we would have seen Justin, but whatever.
We just found ourselves. It was meant to be. If it's meant to be, it'll be. Oh, and then we went to It's Sugar. I really hope it's not too crazy because I want to meet my baby Clay. I just love him so much.
People went to the airport.
I should have went to the airport.
Are we there? Are we there yet?
Aren't we like a block away?
I don't know.
I brought a jacket because I thought it was going to be freezing
out. I was going to bring a jacket. Look, it's Zane's apartment.
Hi, Zane.
Zane and Gigi.
Zane lives there. Just exposed his apartment.
Zane and Gigi.
Love them. Okay. Bye. We out here. Excited?
Yeah, I'm so excited. I'm hungry.
Protect Clay Jensen at all costs.
Hi. Welcome to Joelle Vlogs.
Joelle Vlogs.
Joelle G.
We love one man.
What are you gonna do about that?
Rock stars. So season 2 came out on Friday. How has this been, Dylan, for you over the weekend? How has the reception been? What have you been seeing from fans?
I mean, to be honest, I haven't been on my phone very much. I've kind of put it down. For the weekend, I've been kind of just locked in my house. I kind of did a similar thing last year. Like when the show came out, I was in my house all weekend, and then the whole first week it was out, I was cat sitting for some friends. So I did not venture out into the world at all when the show came out, and then it was kind of a shock when I first went outside and people started coming up to me about the show. But anyway, this year it's similar, kind of haven't gone outside yet, but it's my first time out since the show came out, really.
Were you cat sitting this time around too?
No, I'm not cat sitting.
You know that your storyline would kind of evolve. Did you kind of all of you get that sense that your characters would get a little more in depth with the second season?
Yeah, I think all of us talked with Brian Yorkey like before the season started, and he gave us a lowdown on what was going to happen. So he kind of told me what was going to happen. Yeah, I mean,
Ryan's very need to know.
Yeah.
Like none of us kind of knew.
With yours, I think maybe he kept it a little bit under wraps because that is scary. Well. I kept it a secret from you guys. We're in character right now. No, you told me about it and I was excited. So yeah, this has been great. And thank you guys for all the support.
Yeah. Way, Hannah's still around.
Yeah.
Here, but.
Yeah, I mean, I think Clay, for the most part, is really good at putting up a wall and kind of, and consolidating his emotions for other people. But I think deep down he is a really angry, kind of tortured soul, and you saw that a lot in season one. You saw it come out a bit, but you see it come out a lot in season two. And what doesn't help the fact is that, yes, he is still living with the memory of Hannah, quite literally. I mean, he imagines her with him all season, and he cannot put her to rest, and it kind of drives him to a breaking point, as we see. And for me, it was all about making sure that, you know, I didn't know as much about where Clay was going to end up at the end of season two like I did in season one, but I had an idea. And I wanted to make sure that, you know, it tracked and that you are seeing Clay go in kind of a downward spiral throughout the season. So I wanted to make sure that all felt real. And luckily the writing was super consistent and all made a lot of sense for Clay, so it made it easier on me. But there was definitely new places to explore with Clay this year. You really got to kind of go even deeper into his psyche and see what's going on. And it's not pretty, but I think, you know, but Clay seems to be on a path to recovery by the end, which is good, but I don't think Clay will ever fully recover. I mean, I don't think any of these kids will, right? It's kind of...
Were you surprised by that story choice, Devin?
Yeah, I think it was kind of, everyone was kind of interested to see how that was gonna play into the story. But I think it's really amazing to see how Dylan really is, you know, a master of his craft and how he plays that role and kind of, yeah, you can smile, it's okay. And just, you know, the way that it's kind of formulating his conscience and the way that he's, you know, dealing with grief and letting go of someone that he cared so deeply about. And I think it played really well, especially in the way that, again, you just being so great as your character and just playing all the emotions in the right way and, you know, showing that grief and that trauma, I think is really something that's...
Right back at you, man.
Thank you,
thanks.
Give this character kind of a redemption a little bit, where she was able to open up about her own story and get a little bit of closure.
I was incredibly excited because the last episode where she finally tells her dad, in my eyes, was the beginning of everything, of her actually admitting to herself what happened and her road to recovery. And I feel like that's not covered a lot in TV shows or film, is the road to recovery of a survivor at all. And I was so incredibly excited to be able to explore that storyline, because it's tough and it takes a really long time, and people don't realize how permanently it affects you and how it affects your day-to-day life and what you have to go through, including you know, anxiety disorders, PTSD, and we really get to see Jessica struggle with all of that and learn the importance of having a strong support system and being able to talk about it. And on the flip side of it, I think by filming the second season, I learned the right way to be there for someone who's going through that thing, because it's very hard, because as you see my dad, like he, in the show, he loves me and he doesn't always have the right answers. He doesn't know exactly what to do at times, but you see him change gears when he figures out that something doesn't work for Jessica. He's like, okay, let's do a different thing. Let's not be this, let me not be that aggressive. We'll be ready, I'll be there for you when you're ready to talk. So it was a huge learning experience for me personally, but I was so excited to really tell Jessica's story, because unfortunately it happens so much and it's incredibly relevant, and I really feel like it's such an important story, especially for young girls.
And there's a really...
So, I love the cast of 13 Reasons Why so much. It was really cute. I love my boy Clay, protect him at all costs.
I'm not like looking to see like what way I have to go.
Angie's leaving me now, that's really sad.
She's gonna hopefully get home, my home to work area.
She's gonna work, she's gonna go to the dentist.
Bye vlog.
Say bye vlog.
Bye.
Bye. Now I have to be all alone. Listen, someone needs to get Dylan to date me. Play Jensen, protect him at all costs. Okay, bye.